In the Oireachtas today, a number of questions were tabled at the Minister for Finance relating to last week's budget, with the Minister being pushed on a number of issues by Labour leader Deputy Eamon Gilmore.
The options facing us now, Cian Corla, are stark.
You haven't answered my question.
We as a nation cannot allow...
You have not answered my question.
We cannot allow...
You have not
Gilmore.
Answered my question. You refuse to answer
with
my...
With all due respect, f*** you, Deputy Gilmore.
Deputy Lennon, this is most unparliamentary language. Please
I realise it was most unparliamentary language, Cian Corla. I withdraw it and I apologise.
Well, I will be Deputy seeking a suspension.
Quiet, Deputy Gilmore.
There soon followed a heated debate, with the Taoiseach jumping to the defence of the Minister for Finance.
Well, obviously in the current climate, Cian Corla, tempers can become a little frayed.
We need a full written apology, Taoiseach, and that's what Deputy Gilmore...
Cian Corla, he's already apologised going forward.
Yes, I have.
Deputy Gilmore is seeking a full written apology, Taoiseach, and that's the size of the matter as we speak.
Deputy Gilmore can f*** off, Cian Corla.
Retract that statement immediately, Taoiseach. I'm afraid...
I will in me b***h, Cian Corla. Deputy Gilmore has been a anchor, with respect.
He's a p***, Cian Corla. I withdraw that.
Enda Kenny, the leader of Fine Gael, later became very agitated during question time.
Using that kind of
Deputy Kenny. Deputy Kenny.
Taoiseach, you and your friends in this godforsaken government... think you're very tough altogether. Well, I've only one thing to say to you. Feck you. Right, and double feck. And you know what? I'll throw in another one. Feck. Feck that as well. I withdraw it immediately, Cian Corla.
No need to withdraw, Deputy. It's only mildly offensive.
Well, what about this? Bloody hell, Cian Corla. What about that?
Tame, Deputy. Sit down, Deputy.
Former Taoiseach and backbench TD Bertie Ahern then entered the Dáil, but was roundly criticised for not turning up for last week's budget vote.
And he has consistently shown flagrant disregard, Cian Corla, for Dáil procedure.
Deputy.
Born out of his arrogance.
Deputy.
The arrogance of 12 years of untrammelled power.
Deputy, do you know the five lamps?
What about the five lamps?
Hang your b***s out of it, you prick.
Deputy.
Take that back, please.
You and your f***ing poetry. You're a pain in the f***. Hole, talking sh** for the last 30 years, you stupid b****s.
Cian Corla, I don't have to take this sh**.
Deputy.
He's well out of f***ing order, Cian Corla.
Ah, f*** off.
After this episode, everybody started weighing in, with the worst and most colourful vitriol coming from Kerry Deputy Jackie Healy-Ray.
Withdraw that immediately, Deputy.
I let you know the fool about Giddy.
Deputy, you can't call somebody that.
Cliana fool, you're
right, that's it. Leave the chamber, Deputy. Leave the chamber. Leave the chamber, Deputy. Deputy Noonan.
Ah, yeah. For f*** sake, Cian Corla. Nothing like a good old f*** Barney, huh? Huh? Huh?
Deputy Burton.
Can I just say, Cian Corla, you can't f*** and do that
Deputy
to
Burton.
The people. They simply won't f***ing tolerate
Deputy
it.
Burton.
I'm f***ing telling ya!
Proceedings inevitably descended into farce, with Deputy Enda Kenny attempting to regain lost ground with a spontaneous rendition of Lily Allen's F*** You. Sorry, I'll withdraw that.
F*** you. F*** you very, very much. F*** off. Cause we hate what you do, and we hate your whole crew, so please don't stay in touch. F*** you, f*** you very, very much. Cause your words don't translate, and it's getting quite late, so please don't stay in touch.